welcome to Geek Lord. I would say low budget, but that's kind of the slogan for our other podcast I forgot. You should also listen to. Today, we've officially started our episodes for individual
Geek
characters.
Lord.
So I'm going to pick a character, Laura's going to pick a character, and we're going to talk about them. I picked, well, I kind of picked off Bane, but I don't know whether I want to do that yet. So, Laura, you can start with General Grievous.
Do you have enough info on him?
Kind of.
General Grievous was a Kalish warrior. And he was a rebel warlord for his planet Kalish when the Republic got involved with a war going on.
Some people here.
War in Kalish, and General Grievous stood up for all the poor people suffering and became a warlord. So this happened, catching the eye of many separatists. This is around 2 to 5 years after Phantom Menace, and Count Dooku orders that Grievous's ship be destroyed. So when General Grievous has a ship destroyed, and he is pretty much dead, but his vital organs are alive, so his heart, his ribs, his brain, you know, all that kind of stuff, and it gets put into a robotic suit. That makes him a cyborg. From then on, he became a Jedi hunter and put fear in many Jedi. He captured Egg and Coline the Clone Wars, and he killed the Darth Evan in the Clone Wars as well. So he was definitely an evil man, evil cyborg.
And he wielded Jedi. The weapons of the Jedi he killed. He also had 4 arms.
Yeah, so
with spinning
he had
hands.
More than 4 lightsabers, didn't he? But he only used 4 in combat because he had 4 arms.
And he could spin his hand round so they went like really fast. I would recommend watching Obi-Wan vs. General Grievous. I'll hopefully put a link in the description. I might not, but you know. I don't know actually. I'm not going to put a link in the description. Forget it.
And, he refused to use red lightsabers as it didn't incriminate the Jedi so much. He preferred to use Jedi's weapon. So that's how he won so many battles against Jedi. But for the Nadar Veb one, he just used a gun.
He killed Nadar Veb with a gun. Is he Admiral Akbar's species? I haven't watched Clone Wars.
Yeah, Mon Cala.
Yeah. They made they made basically another General Grievous. They made General Grievous and stuck his head on it in Legends.
Mm-hmm. So, as you can tell, I didn't, in the last episode you would have known, but, well, we did an episode but we deleted it. And I couldn't think of a character, so it was just me looking through a encyclopedia the whole time.
The thing is, we're supposed to pick characters, but we've completely finished General Grievous, and we're 3 minutes in.
Because I can try and find a new character if you want.
Okay. I was going to do Darth Bane, okay? He was a Sith Lord that introduced the Rule of Two, so he was that weird guy with the weird black ink under his eyes, but
yeah, he had stuff on his eyes, didn't he?
So he was born on a Republic controlled planet, and his name was Desil. So his father was like a horrible person and just beat him up and stuff. And one day he became a builder, well, a miner on his planet. And so it made him strong, basically. And one day he decided, his father, he was like, no, I'm not listening to you anymore. And then he beat him. No, I mean the father beat Desil, which is Darth Bane, until he was almost dead. So when he laid in bed that night, he imagined him squeezing his father's heart and then killing him. And when he woke up, his father had died. So, he didn't know how, but he joined the... He joined... He needed to get some money. So, people thought he was responsible for the death, so he had to live in exile. And he needed to get some money, so he decided to gamble. And because he was Force-sensitive, although he didn't know, he used the Force to manipulate his opponents and always won the gambling. Always won when he played it. Sabak. He won against a Republic fighter once, and they got really angry, so they tried to kill him in the street. But, and one of his father's drunken friends tried to hit him when he killed his father accidentally. But, he dodged out of the way and bit his thumb off. So he said it was self-defense. But so this is the second time he'd attacked someone. So he couldn't claim it self-defense, especially as there were no witnesses. So the man came across and Revan hit him across the face so hard he basically died. So the other two of the other Republic fighters that knew him ran over to come and arrest him. So he ran into the bar and his friend, the barman, said, I'll get you a ship out of this planet. Go and live on the planet. Go and train with the Sith. So, not as a Sith Lord, but as a Sith fighter. So, he only had a gun. He didn't have any lightsabers or anything. He was called a Gloomwalker. So, he went to that planet and became a Gloomwalker and fought for the Sith. He was really good, and because he kept winning his battles, the Sith Lord, I can't remember his name. I don't have much information, but noticed how good he was. So he thought, okay, why don't you come and train in the Sith Academy with the Brotherhood of Darkness? So he said, okay, sure. He went with them, and he trained there for ages. One of the, I forgot his name. See, I'm not very good at this, but, you know, I know quite a lot about Bane. I don't know all the separate characters, but there was a really, he was getting better and better, and then attended private lessons with the, with Sith teachers. And one day he challenged the star pupil, okay, the best guy there. And his Force, because he was scared of like what he could do with his Force powers, he didn't embrace them, so his Force powers went away. He thought under pressure they would go back, so he challenged the star pupil, but they didn't come back, and he was completely I don't know how to explain it. Well, let's just say beat. Yeah, he was completely beat up and finished. So all the teachers looked down on him then, and they didn't let him have any private lessons, but he did it anyway. He decided to have private lessons with himself and go into the Jedi Banks archives. So he decided, I'm gonna do that. And then after a while he challenged him again, and this time he won. He accidentally killed him. So the Sith Lord said, right, you can't just kill another pupil, you're exiled. And seeing as we said you're not having any lessons or going into the archives and you did anyway, you're exiled. He said, fine, I'm going to exile. So he went to Korriban to see the Valley of the Dark Lords because he wanted to learn more about them. And he found Revan's holocron. Darth Revan was my favourite character other than Kit Fisto. So, he found his holocron, and while he was on that planet, I forgot. Right, he discovered about the rule of two, and he decided that only two Sith Lords should live, because the Brotherhood of Darkness was rubbish, because Sith, there should be a master, one above all. You can't just have all equals, so he decided to tell the Brotherhood of Darkness where he was, so they would follow him. And he found... it's called, he decided he would use a move called the Thought Bomb, okay? He's really powerful. So when the Brotherhood of Darkness came, they thought, okay, this could actually be a good idea. Because Darth Bane had also told the Republic that the Sith Lords were here. So the Sith and the Jedi were here. So what happened was, he wanted to destroy them both. So he told them about the Thought Bomb. So they went into this cave, so it wouldn't be like completely destroy the whole planet. They went into this cave to do the Thought Bomb. They thought it wasn't going to work. So the head of the Sith Lord, the head of the Brotherhood of Darkness, tried to force manipulate Malgus so he wouldn't do it. But Malgus basically repelled it. So now he was in control of the leader of the Brotherhood of Darkness. So he told them to do the Thought Bomb, and they did. The Jedi also came and followed the Sith into the cave. They did the Thought Bomb, and all of them completely just perished, and their souls stayed in the cave. It almost wiped out all the planet. Revan, Darth Bane was just walking along, and he found a girl called Rain, and she had killed two Jedi with just raw force abilities. They were lying next to her. So he thought he's going to take him as an apprentice. Her cousin was there as well. I think his name was like Dorian or something. So she didn't want Bane to kill Dorian. So she destroyed Dorian's hand with her force powers so Malak wouldn't kill him. So she decided she was going to be a Sith because she hated the Jedi because they were going to kill her. But she basically knocked out two Jedi. So they trained for ages in darkness, and they were sent each other on different missions. And one day, Bane went to a temple and found these creatures. They're Sith creatures called Orbalisks. And they tried to attack him. Two of them latched onto him, and it was really painful. Like, super, super painful. So Darth Bane realised that this was one of the strongest armour ever. It was basically impenetrable, but it was the most painful thing ever. But he thought he could feed on the pair, which would make him more powerful. So he did that, and he wore the obelisks then on. So one day he was battling this Sith. I can't remember anything. Well, I know he was...
It's a very long story, isn't it?
Yeah. Go watch some good people review it, like Civilization X or something. So, there was a blockade of Jedi there that had survived with the Thought Bomb, and they were basically the only ones left. And Xana called them over to Darth Bane. So Xana brought the Jedi to Darth Bane because she thought that she knew that Darth Bane would defeat them. So then they would he would destroy all the Jedi. So she wanted to lead him to Bane because she couldn't destroy him on her own yet. She was only an apprentice. So she did that, but he killed almost all of them, but one of them. So Malgus was about to kill the last one using Force Lightning, but he created a Force bubble around Darth Bane, reflecting the lightning on him. His Orbalisk cracked and kind of went into him. So he was almost dead, but he went to this healer, Caleb, and threatened to kill his daughter so he would heal him. And he did. So
this is a long story.
He thought Xana had betrayed him, so he was going to kill her, but then she told her plan that he knew he would destroy the Jedi, so that's why she did it. And they did that, and Xana did that again. This time she did want Malgus to, Bane to die. So he did survive with bad injuries, but he got Caleb to fix him again. So he decided to just forget Xana and train someone else, Darth Cognos. But at that time, there was three Sith Lords, which couldn't happen. So, he decided to challenge Xana to get it over with. And the one who won would get to train Cognos. So, they had a battle. Bane almost completely destroyed Xana, but Xana let out Sith. I forgot what they're like. They're like Sith shadows. So they're these big shadows that come out, and if they touch you, you die. So Bane just dodged them all and was about to hit Xana when a random one flew by and sliced his arm off. Okay? So he had to do one last thing, and he'd learnt about essence transfer in Darth Adendu's holocron. So he decided to do that, and he tried to put his soul into Xana's body. So for 1 minute, he was in Xana's body. So Darth Bane's mind was in Xana's body. But when you do essence transfer, your body goes into another person's body, and whoever's stronger emerges victorious, and Xana was stronger. So Malgus's soul was cast into, you know, just the abyss, and he was gone. So Xana eventually trained Cognos, and then it went on and on and on from there. Also, Xana's lightsaber is the one that NK Cronus used. So that was a long story, but we're exactly 15 story. Minutes now. So, trivia of the day.
Okay.
Did Star Wars right. kids hear anything? Oh, by the way, we'll say that at the end of the episode about Geekland. So stay tuned to the end of the episode. Try not to skip, but I don't know if it really matters. Does it matter? It probably should, because you'll see all them people on YouTube
know.
Be like, don't
we,
skip.
I didn't know we'd have enough time to fit it all in, so I got my book, and I'm going to explain some more characters.
Okay. So what's your trivia, though?
Okay, does it have to be a Star Wars one, or does it have to be, like, another geek, or can it be another geek talk?
It can be anything, to be honest.
Alright. Who else was running for Prime Minister in 2019 against Boris Johnson?
That's not geeky.
You said anything. Alright. Something geeky.
Wait, let me guess who it was, though. I've forgotten now.
Jeremy Hunt.
Oh, and Michael Gove.
No, Jeremy Hunt was against Boris Johnson.
Okay. Right.
My question then.
I'll do one. In The Hobbit, or in just Lord of the Rings, okay, where was Mount Doom, which is where Dark Lord Sauron
was
destroyed?
Well, isn't Dark Lord Sauron the guy who's played by Christopher Lee, Count Dooku guy?
Yeah, no, that's Sauron. Sauron is the guy with a big, you know, armor. Not a Balrog.
They were in Mars.
No.
I don't know.
Mordor! Come on!
I don't watch Lord of the Rings.
You should have known about Mordor, even if you've never heard of Lord of the Rings.
Yeah, okay. My question to you, I still haven't thought of one.
While you're listening...
Name all seven Horcruxes.
Name all seven Horcruxes. Okay, alright. Right. The Poveral Ring. That belonged to Marvel O'Gaunt. Helga Hufflepuff's cup. The lost diadem of Rowena Ravenclaw. Slytherin's locket. Tom Riddle's diary. Nagini. Harry.
That is... Oh, yeah. You got all 7 right.
Hooray!
All right. Oh, yeah. I don't think we're going to have time to fit all of this in an episode. So, I brought my brain and my knowledge to my chair because I needed to charge my phone. And I'm going to tell you a story of all these clones. Well, all the important ones. Wolfie, the leader of the clone squad known as the Wolf Pack and the Jedi Master Plo Koon, he survived the Order 66 and then retreated to planet where he was reunited with Rex and Gregor and Rebels. Dogma, he is a member of the 501st and is mostly recognized for killing.
I don't think this is going to be a popular episode, to be honest.
Alright, and Fives, who's an archtrooper and he discovered the inhibitor chips and then died when Clone Commander Fox shot him. Echo, an archtrooper, seemingly dead in the Citadel, but it turned out he wasn't dead. There we go, another member of the 501st. Clone Commander Cody, he was a Martian of the 7th Sky Corps, was it? And he worked closely with Jedi Master Kenobi. Rex, Lord Brave Archtrooper in 501st, fall on Anakin, and then he survived and took his inhibitor chip out in Order 66, and he became friends with the Rebellion. Hardcase, reckless but deadly with his rotative cannon. Hardcase did nothing, sacrificed his life to save his squad during the Battle of Umbara. Waxer, a member of Ghost Company, worked to help liberate Ryloth and Geonosis, killed as a result of Von Kell's treachery on Umbara. Tark, nice guy, until he went crazy after his inhibitor chip went crazy, and he tried to kill a Jedi, and he did. Jesse, you didn't see the episode that came out on May the 4th yesterday? Don't listen, because he died, by the way.
Shush, you can't spoil it for me! I'm gonna watch that in like 10 years, you know? I didn't even hear what you said, though.
Yeah, because all the clones look the same, you never tell which one's which, and you're like... But they all have different markings on them, so you have to remember which marking is whose. Heavy, just a guy who goes crazy and died in a battle that no one cares about. 99, a failed deformed clone, who, when he died, he had a squad named after him. Called Clone Force 99 or something, and he was on maintenance duty. That is all the important clones.
Nice.
Is there any others?
Should we announce our new Prime Minister?
What? What did you say?
Should we announce our new Prime Minister?
I thought he said he didn't want to be one.
Yeah.
He said he wanted to be, He said he wanted to be something else.
A warlock. That's his species.
He wanted to be a warlock.
Yeah, I know. A warlock's a species.
Yeah.
Warlocks can be prime minister.
Yeah. All right. So.
Right. I'm gonna do some fancy editing. Today we are giving an important message to address the nation. We have elected a new Prime Minister of Geekland. This man has been elected by the public, which is coincidentally only us three. Me, Laurie, and the Prime Minister. He has chosen his party as canon, but regards that he will see to to legends as allies and respect their beliefs, like Chewbacca died under the moon of Yavin. Now, we would like to announce as our Prime Minister... full name is the Right Honourable Sir Lucas George de Fuffle Star Wars Kiddington. And we welcome him greatly to our country to lead our parliament. But we need a new name for parliament. Put it down in the comments.
Predicament.
Yeah. He is, by the way, we've come up with a name for Trend Keepers. And it's basically our motto. I put it on our flag, which I'm now putting a picture of on the editing thing. It's called Custodonians. So, Custodonians means keeper in Latin. So, that is going to be like keepers up with the trend. So, anti-custodotion is what we believe in. Anti-keeping up with
any
the trend.
Any person caught keeping up with these trends will be severely punished.
Like, the new Prime Minister, horrible person called Max, who doesn't like him at all. He is the best definition of a Custodonian, along with Pencilhead. So, they are the form of people we will not allow in our society of Geekland.
So, Max and Pencilhead and Colossalhead are for now banished and not permitted to enter the walls of Geekland.
On the flag it says "Sit vis vobiscum omnis," which means "May the force be with you all" in Latin. Another, like, another Easter egg. Also, it says the Prime Minister's informal name, Star Wars Kid, on there. But his formal name is the Right Honourable Sir Lucas George de Fuffle Star Wars Kiddington.
Yes.
He is also leader of the Warlocks founder. He has led Warlocks into complete equality, as Warlocks were seen as lower than normal just geeks, but he has brought together and is the first Warlock Prime Minister of Geekland, or just the first Prime Minister ever.
No longer shall goblins and gremlins be at war.
And he believes in Warlock equality, along with goblins and gremlins, whatever you want to call them.
And gargoyles.
Yeah, but gargoyles are made of stone. Goblins are living, and so are gremlins. What about a hobgoblin, though?
He has given votes to hobgoblins too. They are now allowed to vote.
Now, we would do a funny little wave, but this is audio only. So, let's just play. We need to make a national anthem.
Suggest the words and maybe tune for the national anthem in the comments. Somehow do the tune. I don't know. Just say, make
put like a treble clef in there.
The most precious song in the world, God Save the Queen.
We're going to work on a national anthem. I'll work on it, Laurie, and send you a recording. And hopefully...
We need to do the Star Wars rap as well.
Yeah. But we're working on a national anthem for our country. We're going to put the flag up as this royal march has been on. And then just, like, some people saluting.
Can you print it onto some silk or something and make a giant flag or banner and start waving it around?
Yeah, I don't know how to do that, though.
Alright, so the bedrooms that we sleep in are now under our property, the property of Geekland.
Yeah.
This is the closest thing to Geekland we have in our home. If you consider yourself a citizen, report to us for your legal work, and then your bedroom could turn into Geekland.
You can also be a nobleman of Geekland if you just suggest a name for our places. We need a name. We really badly need a name for our capital city, so try and suggest it, anybody, even Star Wars kids.
Are you sure Geekland is really, an effective name, though?
Yeah. Finland? England?
Yeah, but those names don't actually describe it, because Ing isn't a word.
England.
Is it?
Geekland.
Ing isn't.
I think Geekland's a fine name, and I put it on the flag, so I ain't changing it.
Alright.
Thank you for listening. Look at our other podcast that I forgot. So, just come up with a name for the place, and we'll make you a nobleman, or come up with a good joke, and you can be a jester. You know, anybody, just say what you want to say. Thank you for listening, and goodbye.
I'm surprised Star Wars kid hasn't actually done a joke yet. But then again, he's Prime Minister.
Yeah, you can't be Prime Minister and a jester at the same time. Anyway, goodbye.
Imagine it, because he'd have to be two people at once. Someone needs to entertain the Prime Minister. The jester. Hello, Mr. Prime Minister. Hello. How are you?
Goodbye.